Hi everyone. In this video, we are going to try to understand what a wave packet really is. We know that the concept of wave packets was introduced to us by Louis de Broglie in 1924. So it is often referred to as the de Broglie hypothesis. He said that waves can behave like particles, and particles can likewise behave like waves. And he also gave a famous relation equating a particle with a wavelength. Till the time we never associate a wavelength with any particle, for the first time he gave a relation lambda equals h over p, meaning that the momentum of a particle is directly proportional to the wave number that we can associate with a similar wave. For explaining the properties of particles that can behave like a wave, he considered a particle as a localized wave, which we call a wave packet. A wave packet is a group of superimposed waves which together form a traveling localized disturbance, and the equation of which can be described by Schrodinger's equation. How do we produce a wave packet? We can produce a wave packet by superimposing several waves which are slightly differing in their wave numbers, because we know that the concept of de Broglie hypothesis equated that the momentum of a particle is related to its wave number. And from Heisenberg's uncertainty principle, we know that the momentum, the uncertainty in momentum multiplied by the uncertainty in its position is a constant. And from Heisenberg's uncertainty principle, we know that if there is no uncertainty in the momentum or wave number, then you cannot localize the wave. There is an infinite uncertainty in its position, and such a wave can behave only like a wave, and you cannot attribute any particle nature to it. On the contrary, if there is a small uncertainty in its momentum, which can be taken as a small uncertainty in its wave number, now such a particle can be represented by a host of waves, each differing by a small wave number. And superimposing all these waves together, we will get what is called a localized wave packet. And it can explain how a particle can have wave attributes. We'll see that in a small Python program segment next. I have already saved the program segment so that we can easily execute and see how a wave packet is formed. For this, I require two libraries, and I'm importing these two libraries here. For describing a wave, I require two parameters. One is time, the other one is the displacement of the wave about its mean position. Now I will consider 2000 points, each differing by a small fraction of a time equal to 0.01 seconds. And now I define the displacement of this wave as a sine omega into t. Here the time is represented by the variable k here. The wave is now described by the amplitude is taken as 1. So a equal to 1 sine 2 pi f into t. Here the frequency is 1000 hertz and I am plotting time against a displacement. And this is the wave that I get and it is expected. Now this is the equation of a wave which changes with time. Now what I do is, I try to superimpose two waves one over the other. So superposition of two waves is allowed by the property of interference that we can attribute to waves. Here I am taking the same example, the only difference is that I am superpositioning two waves one over the other. One has a frequency of 1000 hertz and the other has a frequency which does not vary too much from the other one. It is only 1001 hertz. Now I am plotting the superposed waves together. Now I find this beautiful pattern which in sound is called beats. When you have two waves which does not differ too much in terms of frequency when they superimposed, you have a waxing and waning in sounds which we call beats. You get a similar waveform here also. Now instead of two waves, we get a wave packet by a very large number of waves, each differing by a very small value in wave number. Instead of taking frequency and time, I am now going to consider momentum and position. According to Heisenberg's uncertainty principle, momentum and position, they are a pair of canonically conjugate variables, and therefore an increased precision in one of these quantities leads to a decreased precision in the other. If you are able to find the value of momentum or the wave number to a very high precision, it automatically reduces the precision that you can expect in the position of the particle. And therefore what I do is, I go to this, I am taking wave number and position and I am taking 2000 different values for wave number, each differing by a very small quantity of say 0.1. And I am considering the same 2000 different values for position. Now you can see what are all the values of wave number that I have. See, each wave number is separated by a very small value. 9900, 9900.1, 9900.2 and so on. So you find that I have a very large number of wave numbers. I am considering all these wave numbers and what I do next is, I take each of these 2000 positions that I am considering right now. And for each wave number, I am finding the displacement or the superposition of all the 2000 waves having all those 2000 different wave numbers. See, wave number here is represented by J. And I is its position. I am considering its position now. For various positions, I am trying to find out the superposition of all these 2000 waves at each and every position. And I'm finally plotting, and I get a beautiful wave pattern like this. Here the x-axis is position, and I find that the wave is very much localized within this region, and beyond a certain point in time, I find that the wave actually interferes destructively, and the probability of finding the particle at extreme points from the center is very much close to zero. Now this wave packet, which is now composed of nearly 2000 different waves, can act like a particle. So this is what is a wave packet. And we believe light behaves as a wave packet when it is able to eject electrons, which are particles, from metallic surfaces during the process of photoelectric emission. It is this localization of a wave in a very small region in space which gives the photons the punch to eject electrons from metallic surfaces. And what happens when we increase the certainty in the wave number? If there is no uncertainty, or if the wave number is known to a higher precision, I'll add one more zero here, or two more zeros here, which means I know the value of wave number 100 times more precise than previously known in the earlier experiment. Now when I plot, I find that there is a large uncertainty in its position, and the wave now does not behave like a wave packet. It is not a localized wave packet anymore.